recognize some of those folks? Hello again, everybody. For Dave Brown, this is Lance Russell saying a very good day to you on our USWA Championship Wrestling. Corey off again. We're going to have a word with him about that.
He keeps show up for work. Huh?
I'll tell you, he's the loser because, again, we've got something I think you're going to enjoy today.
Oh, man, we've got all kind of action today. Opening match of the day, we got Tommy Rich, Doug Gilbert, Gorgeous George III coming in here. A little bit later on, we'll have the unified world champion superstar Bill Dundee. He's got a tough match against Crusher Bones coming up here today. Brian Christopher will be here a bit later on. And we got a special challenge match with Wolfie D going against Spellbinder. But that's not all. We've got other things to be talking about, too.
You better believe it. We've got an update on J.C. Ice today, and we'll be bringing you that, tell you how he's doing. Also, we've got some news on an interesting pile driver elimination match that's coming up during the week, and I think everybody will want to hear about that. And, of course, as you've already said, we got quite a main event with Wolfie and Spellbinder getting ready to go. What do you say we take our time right now, and we'll be back with that.
There's got to be a better way.
After a long drive, why drive around in a strange town looking for a place to stay at a fair price? Just call Our House, Guesthouse International, a cooperative of independently owned and operated hotels throughout the United States. We'll do our best to find you a clean and comfortable place to stay within your budget.
Be our guest at one of the Guesthouse affiliates nationwide. If there's no room at the inn, or if there's not a guest house where you want to stay, we'll even try to find you a room at one of our competitors. No other hotel chain will do that for you.
After all, we want you to be our guest. No matter where you stay, just call us at 1-800-21-GUEST. That's 1-800-214-8378, and we'll do our best for you.
Remember, you're always welcome at Our House.
Ever try to rent a car without a major credit card? I did. I found out how humiliating it is to be turned down after waiting 30 minutes in line. Okay, I admit it. I've had some credit problems. But nothing prepared me for this experience. Never again. Now I've got real security, a Visa Classic secured credit card. Nobody turns this down. I get rental cars and cash anytime I need them worldwide. Yes, you can carry this card regardless of past credit. Call this toll-free 800 number and call right now for a secured line of credit. Be ready for emergencies. Get cash at banks and automatic teller machines worldwide. Discover how easy it is to qualify. Call this toll-free 800 number now. And this won't happen to you. Ever.
Yeah, next time you think about walking into one of those situations, just have a couple of guys like Wolfie's dad and Mabel walking right alongside of you. Speaking of Wolfie, we want to get the man out here. He had Mabel. He had his dad. But let me tell you one thing about this young man, and we're going to ask him about it. He, all of a sudden, he turned off some kind of double-aught vicious. Wolfie D. Just talking about what happened to you over the past week, I don't believe. I've seen you and J.C. get a little pesky with some people, but I never saw you turn off as vicious as you have over this past week, man.
Lance Russell, J.C. Ice, and Wolfie D started out. We tried to go out there and we tried to wrestle Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert, and it didn't work. And you want to talk about being vicious? That's why. Look what they did to my main man, J.C. He's got a neck brace on. He could have been crippled. He could never wrestle again if he wasn't the man that he is. So Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert, it's going to take a mean streak, and maybe you've put it in me, and maybe you've created a monster. And there's something else. Everywhere I go, everybody wants to know, where's J.C. Ice? How's he doing? Well, I got a big surprise for you. JC Ice, come on out, baby.
Whoa. We had said earlier that we were going to get an update on JC's condition, but I didn't know that he was mobile. Yeah, there he is. Boy, I'll tell you, after what he underwent, I am astounded to see him coming out here at this point, still with a neck brace on. JC, boy, we're glad to see you back here.
And you see, Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert, I'm down, but I ain't out, pal. Because you see, I am one half of the USWA Tag Team Champions. Because JC Ice and Wolfie D said that we would be the USWA Champions and we would stay here for a long, long time. But you see, there's only one good thing about wearing this neck brace. And that is that I am the only one that knows when this neck is ready. So Tommy Rich, Doug Gilbert, Gorgeous George, Spellbinder, and whoever else is watching, when the time comes, JC Ice will let you know. Because when I jerk this neck brace off, woo, there'll be hell to pay, baby.
I believe he's got a little payback in mind in there, Wolfie.
That's right, Lance. And this week, I've asked for the pile driver elimination match. You want to put my man through a table? You want a pile drive? Well, I've learned that maybe I got a pretty good pile driver myself. And Rich, Gilbert, everybody else who wants to get involved in this pile driver match, you just come on down. And I got somebody else who knows something about pile driving. I got somebody that knows how to do a number on him. Another teammate, come on out here, teammate.
Who you got coming out here right now? The unified world.
He's got friends.
Bill Dundee.
The most dangerous move, Lance Russell, the pile driver. And I know this man knows something about it.
I do. You got it right. Now, let me tell you something in front of the whole world. I told you, and I told you, you're thinking with your heart, boys. You're just like Brian Christopher. You think because you're 20 years old, you can sign any kind of match. Who the hell did you pile drive? Some kid that was 90 pounds. That ain't Tommy Rich. That ain't Doug Gilbert. Okay, fine. There you go again. And I'm into it because your last name is Dundee and the pile drive me. Now, son, I've told you. You just don't sign the dotted line because you want to get into some match. You got to think. You think they don't think? When Jerry Lawler put his hair up, who cut it? Tommy Rich. What did he do? Look at you. I told you. Don't get in the cage with a guy. You got to have the edge. But no, no. And Wolfie, you think because you dropped some guy on his head that you can pile drive? Them boys been around a long time. Now, I'm in the match, and you're right. It's going to be one of the roughest and the toughest. And you may have a neck brace on, and I may want to have on. But the good thing is, too, Richard, it happens to you, too. If we drop you on your head, and I don't like you, you bleached blonde punk, and Doug Gilbert, I don't particularly care for you either, because after I whooped up on Gorgeous George, you guys come in and dropped me on my head. I was just lucky it wasn't on a table. Like I said before, brother, I don't get into nothing blind. I gave this a lot of thought. I gave it a real lot of thought, and I'm going to help the two punk kids out, because one's my son, and I happen to like this one. And I'm just going to tell you boys something. As sure as my name is Bill Dundee, what are you getting dropped on your head in the concrete?
I'll tell you one thing, you better listen to what the man says. He's been there, and he's the kind of guy you want to be behind your back when it comes to this kind of a match. That's going to be an interesting situation as we get ready to head up to the ring and put a little action going in here. Coming into the ring right now, Ken Raper, and we've got ourselves a six-man, Dave.
Yes, we do. And headed in across the way, Tommy Rich, Gorgeous George III, and of course, Dangerous Doug Gilbert. GG3, M spraying the, I don't know, perfume, disinfectant, whatever it might be, all around the corner.
Yeah, he makes a big to-do about that, and it's all part of that mystique of Gorgeous George III, but let me tell you, he'll hurt you in a hurry, too. You get thinking about this soft
kind of a guy.
Sacrifice today, Lance Russell. I guarantee you, you said watch this.
Yeah,
that's right. Ooh la la.
Ooh la la. Great. Okay, referee Bill Rush is the man that's going to have to take it all on. We ring it, and here we go. Ken Raper and Corey Williams.
Now, Lance, I know you don't know anything about wrestling, but you watch this Gorgeous George right here, and he might teach you a little bit.
We have already made the point that he has got quite a background, eh? We know it, and you can see it in every match that he has. All three of them have known a little bit about wrestling.
Speaking of background, it's not all pleasant when you talk about Rich and Gilbert and Gorgeous George III. Find himself in trouble. Doug Gilbert right there picking him up. Doug Gilbert hammering with a forearm. Into the turnbuckles across the way. He drives with his shoulder. Doug Gilbert not letting up. Boy, they came out ready to do battle.
Man, oh man, when Rich said they were out there and you're going to see a real sacrifice, I think they knew exactly what they were going to do. Gilbert over there spitting at Ken Raper. Just to bait Raper in to tie the referee up. And look, Corey takes a pop right smack in the chop. Look at that. Rich holding his Gilbert, and Rich is doing the pitching. And look at that, gouging at the eyes. Come on, Bill.
Corey Williams in serious trouble. Doug Gilbert just towering over him there. Now picks him up, center of the ring. Up in the air, snaps him down with a suplex. As he bounces, Doug Gilbert goes to the rope and then drops down on him.
He busted him with that right hand. Absolutely had his head down right on the mat, so there wasn't any give to it. There's a tag to Gorgeous George III, moves around behind, and look at him whip that forearm right across that chin.
Well, I tell you what. Doug Gilbert, Tommy Rich, and Gorgeous George III haven't let up an instant. There's a chokehold by Gorgeous George III.
They've gotten Corey Williams in there, and he has not been able to get over and tag. He hadn't even been able to get near the corner. There he goes. Now, they're going to spread the misery around, because I'll guarantee you, Dave, you pointed it out right to begin with. They came in. Looked like he was going in a suplex, turned it around, 1, 2, 3. Got the win.
Oh, my goodness.
Mercifully.
Power from the opening bell from Rich Gilbert and Gorgeous George III.
All right, Tommy, come on.
A pile driver. Doug Gilbert has Corey Williams. He sets him up for a pile driver.
Nothing's happening in terms of getting this thing stopped. And Rich Gilbert and Gorgeous George III, vicious, just vicious.
Oh, one pile driver after another here. Well, against these young kids, too.
We heard Bill Dundee talk about a little bit earlier. Just because you drop somebody on their head doesn't mean you know how to pile drive. But he said, believe me, Rich and Gilbert know how to pile drive. Look at Gilbert again. Slams Corey's head down in. Get him out of the ring. Good night.
Just won't go away. There's Rich. Rich finally out of the ring. Here they come over this way. All right.
Hey. To do that to anybody.
Well, you guys have proved you can pile drive kids. There's no doubt about that.
This is a man's game, Dave Breath.
And if they don't want to pay the price, then they ain't got no business here.
Dave Brown, you know what has always made USWA a step ahead of every other wrestling organization? You have had such stars as Jerry the King Lawler. You have had such stars as Superstar Bill Dundee. You have had such stars as Wildfire Tommy Rich. And what you have now is you have the future. You have Dangerous Doug Gilbert. You have Gorgeous George. And I can name on and on. Let's see what I'm getting to. Bill Dundee stood out here and he said it takes some brains. And he's exactly right. See what Bill Dundee was saying, Sir Whoopi D, JC Ice, you've locked yourself into all out war. We've shaved your heads. We've about put your eyes out. We've whipped you like dogs. What it boils down to now, boys, we have backed you into the biggest corner of your life. See, you went out. Not only Wolfie D, did you call the WWF and you got big fat Mabel. You went home and you said, Daddy, I'm shaking. They scared me to death. And you got your big old fat, bald-headed, ugly daddy to come. Well, boys, I've heard rumors. I saw Bill Dundee out here and say he was going to help you, JC Ice. You little 150-pound wimp with a flea collar around your neck. Well, boys, you bring Bill Dundee, Mr. Superstar, and you make sure you're thinking. You bring Jerry Lawler, and he better make sure he's thinking. Because, boys, after you saw Tommy Rich's pile driver, after you saw Dangerous Doug's pile driver, there's no future left in professional wrestling for any one of you four jabronis.
You know what it amounts to, Dave Brown? It's boys come to a man's world, and when we get in that ring, it's our world, Jack. Whether it's Jerry the King Lawler, Bill Dundee, Big Fat Mall Mabel, Pile Driver, anything goes. So what that means is, Jack, one at a time, we're going to drop you on your head. And then Wolfie D, when we get rid of Dundee, get rid of Lawler, then get rid of that big fat stinking Mabel, it's going to be you against us three. And you are going to pay the price.
We'll find out in the ring. The match has been signed.
And it's like Tommy said, it's not luck, it's desire. And that's why we're winners.
Well, desire may enter into it on the other side, too, and it's going to be different than pile-driving the kids you did here today. We'll be back in a minute.
Babe Ruth has done it again. How does he do it?
Maybe it was a Baby Ruth. The caramel, the nougat, the peanut-packed power. Baby Ruth from Nestle. This baby gets you going.
Son of a gun protectant. Nothing works better on your car's leather, vinyl, and rubber. It can turn just about anything into a great-looking car.
Nice car.
What, this pile of junk?
Give it the gun with Son of a Gun. And now give your tires a quick kick with one-step tire care.
If I have to fold one more box, I'm going to snap.
Did you say snap? Snap into a Slim Jim! Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim!
He looks like your average, ordinary, everyday mutt. But this dog wears a badge.
Man, that dog is some kind of hero, you know that?
Yeah, so I've been told.
And together with his new partner, he's giving law enforcement a whole new look. Chuck Norris.
Sit.
Top Dog.
Good dog. Good Jake.
Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, April 28th.
Bye, Miss Thompson. Oh, you forgot your
Peepees?
Butterfinger Peepees! Unbelievable snackable balls of crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery...
There you are.
Butterfinger.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger Peepees.
Just spray it on?
Just spray it on.
Quicksilver Wheel Cleaner from Armor All. Just spray it on, and then just spray it off.
That's it?
That's it.
Quicksilver Wheel Cleaner.
Well, they got the young men out of here after the carnage that was wrought by that Gilbert George Rich team, I got to tell you. We talked to Bill Dundee, the Unified World Heavyweight Champion, a little bit earlier in the day. We didn't know we were going to be talking to him at that time, but we did know that we were going to get him out of here and say, boy,
that's a hell of you, son.
See that mess? I mean, that's the kind of stuff right there that absolutely gets you so hot. It's some guys that are participating in. I didn't want to get off on that, but it just irritates me.
See, Lancer, you're like me. You've been around a long time, too, and you've seen it all, and you've been involved in it all. And I keep trying to tell him. I told Christopher, this ain't no boys' game. I told Jimmy and Wolfie, Tommy really doesn't want to beat you 1-2-3, kid. He wants to hurt you. But that's another story. Now, remember last week I came out and we put the little fishbowl out and we pulled out the name?
Yes, sir, you did it.
That's right. You know why we did it?
Luck of the draw.
Because everybody's saying, I never get a title shot. I never get a title shot. Well, they'd pulled out another name, and this week it's Tommy Wildfire Rich. Now, here's a little thing that maybe some of you people don't know. Lancer, I'm going to ask you a trivia question. Who was the youngest NWA World Champion ever?
The youngest, I should know that too. The youngest NWA champion. Bill, you're working on the weakest part of my body, my mind.
Well, I'll tell you. It was Wildfire Tommy Rich. He beat Harley Race in the Omni in Atlanta, Georgia. Now, he was 18 years old. He was full of desire. And a lot of people said it was luck. About a month or so later or whatever it was, he went back and he tried it again. And he got beat by Harley Race because that guy had been around a long time. Now, I don't know if it was luck that made him win it. But he lost it to a guy with an awful lot of experience. But it has rolled on a little longer, hasn't it? It's 15 or 16 years later, and Tommy Rich has been up and down the road just like I have. Well, brother, your name's the one that came out of the... Oh, here we go now.
You should have known I was the youngest world champion. And Dundee, as far as you're concerned, Jack, you was running with me, and you was picking my overflow on the girls out. You couldn't even pick a woman up. I had the world heavyweight title, and let me tell you something. I told your stinking boy I was going to shave his head. We said we was going to break his neck. Well, we broke his neck. So, Dundee, I want that title. And this bitch, Bo, you'll wish that you'd got...
Tommy, you're looking for trouble. Always looking for trouble.
Just like the old West, brother. He wants to have the edge all the time. No, I ain't that stupid, Rich. You got your time coming, and we're just going to see how big and bad he is, Lance. I'm sorry for the interruption.
Oh, but you can't Billy, sound I'm sorry. To do
that, but you ain't winning this.
And I'll tell you what else. You're absolutely right. Sure, he'll bait you to get right up in that ring, and then he'll have dangerous Doug Gilbert. He'll have gorgeous George III, one of them coming out there, or both of them, to jump you if he happens to get in any kind of trouble. Well, I think one thing about it, you're not dealing with any kid right here. You're dealing with somebody that's been around as long as you have, Tommy, and longer. And Dundee jumps in, and there goes Rich. Randy Hale's out trying to get him out of here. Goodness, he finally did get on out of here. Guy just has got a bad attitude.
Yes, he does. But you're exactly right. I mean, I could just see all of a sudden all of his buddies unloading out of the dressing room and jumping Bill Dundee. Billy does have a match scheduled here, and no easy opponent, let me tell you. Crusher Bones and over in the corner, Diamond Mike. This is a non-title match. But the Unified World Champion is in action here today against big, tall Crusher Bones.
Crusher, whose running partner from the open roads, as he says he's from, is Big Daddy Cyrus. He's wrestling as a single, trying to get a little single recognition. And he is a big, lanky son of a gun, strong,
wiry, lean, tough. Look at Dundee wrap it up. I mean, he goes to the basics, and as we've said before, Billy's got plenty of that in his background.
And when Crusher is lying on the mat, Billy's taller than he is. Oh, look at that. Ooh.
Now, Bill, I wouldn't have minded if you'd have planted a foot right in that big son of a gun's mouth. Talking about Diamond Mike. Somebody that could really get you irritated, he's one.
Dundee, boot to the midsection. Crusher Bones, not having a very good outing so far here today. Bill Dundee has pretty well been in control. He went for the cover, not able to hold him for a three count. Crusher Bones just moved him out of the way. Diamond Mike, oh, yeah, you're right, running his mouth, trying to distract Bill Dundee.
Non-stop. Crusher Bones is making a mistake. See, he's in there as a single, and he's a fish out of water. He's trying to wrestle. He is a roughhouse fighter. Now, if you want to do that, Dundee will be glad to do that with you. He'd rather wrestle you. And Crusher Bones trying to show he's something that he is not. Now he's starting back in the slam bang style, and he's doing a whole lot better with it. Non-title bout, as Dave said a little bit earlier, and the whip right in there with that clothesline and just followed it and made a forearm ball bat out of it. With a headbutt, Dundee in the corner, wilted down to the bottom rope. The referee saying, hold it, get him out. Ho-ho! Came back in, caught the foot and a right and another one.
Bones made a tactical error. He went into the corner after Dundee. Shouldn't have done it. Oh, Diamond Mike trips Dundee up from outside. Crusher Bones dropping down. Dundee moves out of the way.
Dundee charges in, waist locks him, throws him across the ring, nails Diamond Mike, who had jumped up. One, two, three, got him.
Crusher Bones tried best he could to get that shoulder up. He almost made it, but not quite. Bill Dundee with a victory.
Using what he had talked about earlier, his head, he saw the opening, took advantage when Bones was distracted by running into Diamond Mike, and got the roll up for the pin. Back in just a moment.
Protective. Nothing works better on your car's leather, vinyl, and rubber. It can turn just about anything into a great-looking car.
Nice car.
What, this pile of junk?
Give it the gun with Son of a Gun. And now give your tires a quick kick with One-Step Tire Care.
And
action. Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
Again, please.
Again?
Again.
Art thou bored?
Yeah.
Step into a Slim Jim. Turn to the spice. That baby juicy taste. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim.
The Arkansas Federal Visa MasterCard is now available to you.
I've got one.
You do not have to be rich and famous to carry this lowest rate credit card.
I have one too.
As shown in Money Magazine, the Arkansas Federal Visa MasterCard is ranked the number one credit card in the country. Arkansas Federal is committed to being the number one credit card, unlike other companies that try to lure you in by offering low interest rates and then automatically increasing them 5 to 10% after a few months.
I've got one too.
Arkansas Federal, in addition to the constant low interest rates, offers a 25-day grace period, balance transfer, up to $10,000 credit line, easy access to ATMs, 24-hour-a-day service. Get the real lowest rate credit card from Arkansas Federal. Call 1-800-477-3348 for your free application form. Stop paying more money than you should. Call 1-800-477-3348 to get your application sent to you today.
For the ring right now. And we're just about set to go with action. Referee Bill Rush is in the ring. Here comes the opponent wearing a New York Rangers, what's part of a jersey, I guess. and bringing a hockey stick to the ring with him. This is Chris Kanyon stepping in there to do battle against Brian Christopher.
First time we've had Chris here on our USWA Championship Wrestling. And he's going in pretty high company as he'll be taking on Brian Christopher. Champion, big strapping kid. He came to the ring with a hockey stick, and as you said, the Rangers, I've seen a lot of things carried in there, but I'm not sure I've seen a lot of hockey sticks.
Yeah, me either. And security has removed the hockey stick, I'm happy to report. It's not there so that he could grab it and use it. I guess, I don't know if he's just a big Rangers fan or not. Rangers, of course, defending Stanley Cup champions in the NHL.
Will, I'm sure as time goes along, get a little more information about the background and what the significance of the Ranger shirt and the hockey stick with Chris Kanyon. And the big hip toss from the USWA champion. This is not, as indicated by Dave a little earlier, is not a title match.
Brian Christopher, a few moments ago, hearing the chant from the crowd. The crowd was yelling, super kick, super kick. Brian, very well known for putting his opponents away with a super kick. Well, now, Gorgeous George III has just arrived in the area.
Look at Brian Christopher, repulsive, kissing babies and hugging the obese, fat ladies. Oh, my God, he claims to be too sexy. I am sexy. I am the gorgeous man on this earth. I'm adored by the ladies. I'm envied by the men. And that is why I am the greatest wrestler of all time. And I'm going to defeat Brian Christopher and put the USWA title around my gorgeous waist.
Well, that's why they're going to have the match, to find out who among you is the best. And Brian Christopher right now taking some shots from Chris Kanyon. But a nice reversal! Backdrop right out to the middle of the ring.
Look at this. Fancy maneuvers, bump kicks and all that. He thinks he can wrestle? Out-wrestle me? I am the greatest wrestler of our time. For every hold, I have two counters. I mean, he's a great wrestler, but I am Gorgeous George III, the greatest wrestler of all time.
Better work on a counter for that super kick that Brian Christopher has, because he is flattened a lot of guys with it.
He may have flattened other guys, but he's yet to wrestle Gorgeous George III. You understand that, sir?
And repeating myself, that is why we're having the match. Armbar by Brian.
And he better have a counter for the referee, who may count 1, 2, 3. That'll be the counter he hears, maybe, as he runs into that super kick. But it's not a beauty contest. It's a wrestling match that'll be coming up. Oh, man, what a snap. Chris Kanyon just put on Brian Christopher. Snapped that neck. Brian in some trouble here. Chris Kanyon trying to set him up for a suplex. He got him up in the air, and he drops him down. Whoa.
Took him straight up over. Two big moves, 1, 2, and he couldn't get the third one. It takes 3 to win it.
That's right, it takes 3. And that's what I'm going to do to Brian Christopher. I get my hands on him. I'm going to show him holds he's never seen before. I'm going to take him into a different world, my world of wrestling.
Christopher returning the momentum to his side. Rips the right hand, and a reversal by Chris Kanyon. Leapfrog. There's that super kick. We were talking about it with Gorgeous George III just a moment ago. Christopher over, climbs the ladder to that top rope, comes off the turnbuckle, and drops down across him. Dave, he smashed him.
He got him. It's over. Super kick is what set it up, and then Brian with a smash finishes it off.
Hey, Brian, Christopher, come over here right now. I want to speak with you right now. Come on.
Well, we're going to have a little talking contest right here. And I'm leery of that, because I know Brian's fuse can be a little short at times.
Let me tell you something, Brian Christopher. You disgust me. I do not like anything you stand for, because I know I am a better wrestler than you are, and I'm going to defeat you for that USWA title. Matter of fact, you disgust me. You're smelly. You stink, and I hate things that stink. Matter of fact, I'm going to deodorize the air right now. You better listen to me, Glenn George. Now, I don't know that much about you, but I know now that I don't like you at all. As a matter of fact, you better hope that I don't hate you. Because if I do, and you say I disgust you, well, believe me, my friend, how will you like it when I pull one of them big chains out of my tights and then I bust all the teeth out of your mouth, make them look like a picket fence, my friend? Will you listen right here, Brian Christopher? I am a wrestler. I don't need foreign optics to win. Matter of fact, you take a good look at yourself right now in this mirror, because after I get through with you, you will be a loser. Ooh la la.
Ooh la la. Brian Christopher facing down with Gorgeous George III.
Brian, the match is booked. It'll be settled in a ring.
Fine, you know, it's just like all the rest. They come out here and try to make a name for themselves off of me. Well, that's fine, Gorgeous George, because like I said, you're going to go down in my list of victims on my way of becoming the world heavyweight champion.
Title match is signed later this week. We'll be back in just a moment.
If you've ever wanted to tile a bath, repair a switch, or paper your kitchen like a pro, call this toll-free number now, because we've assembled the essential steps from dozens of home time projects on this phenomenal two-hour video with a handy on-screen index to help you find the steps you need fast. Quick Steps covers it all in the 14 job categories you need now. From plumbing and electrical to paint and wallpaper, you'll pick the right tools, make fewer mistakes, and finish the job on time. It'll help you upgrade every space in your home, from your kitchen and bath to your patio and deck. Try Quick Steps risk-free and also receive Common Home Repairs, an hour-long video that helps you tackle your household headaches once and for all. And you'll get it for a fraction of the price you pay for a service call. I guarantee you'll save double the cost of these videos after just 1 month, or we'll refund your money. Call 1-800-445-8700 to get these best-selling videos for just $24.95 plus shipping, direct from Home Time.
Ever try to rent a car without a major credit card? I did. I found out how humiliating it is to be turned down after waiting 30 minutes in line. Okay, I admit it. I've had some credit problems. But nothing prepared me for this experience. Never again. Now I've got real security, a Visa Classic secured credit card. Nobody turns this down. I get rental cars and cash anytime I need them worldwide. Yes, you can carry this card regardless of past credit. Call this toll-free 800 number and call right now for a secured line of credit. Be ready for emergencies. Get cash at banks and automatic teller machines worldwide. Discover how easy it is to qualify. Call this toll-free 800 number now. And this won't happen to you ever.
Well, I tell you, we've talked about Marcus Dupree and seen Marcus out here before, and I think we automatically assume that everybody knows about the great running of Marcus Dupree. Well, maybe there's some people who haven't seen him, and we're going to give them an opportunity.
And take a look. You're going to see one of the finest running backs in the history of football.
Out of Philadelphia, Mississippi, the Magic Marcus.
You can have anything that you desire.
like not happy we're showing football highlights of Marcus.
Are you kidding me here? Is this pro football or pro wrestling?
Pro wrestling.
Have you people lost your mind?
Pro wrestling.
I am Mr. Football.
You're okay. Mr. Football?
I am Mr. Football. I'm the biggest football fan in the world. Right here. I know all the facts and all the stats. And who is this Marcus Dupree? Are you kidding me? Is this guy a wannabe or what? I've never seen his name on the roster in my life. Okay? This is USWA professional wrestling, not football. And I just want to challenge this guy to bail out now gracefully. Okay? While he has a chance before my men come in and crush him like a grape. Okay? This is pro football. He's overstepped his bounds. This is my world. Okay? I am the sun, and everybody must revolve around me. All right, he's coming out to make an apology.
I don't know if he's coming out to make an apology or not. He's coming out here anyway.
This is your big chance to bail out gracefully, okay? You have no business in the world of professional wrestling. You don't have 10 men on your side, okay? You understand what I'm saying?
Marcus, we were just trying to show some highlights of your career, and he comes out here complaining.
Look, punk, I don't back down from nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing.
It looks like it when you're a pro football, huh? Who are you?
Don't touch me.
I'll touch you. This is my world. Okay? I'm the man in charge around here. You understand me?
Don't touch me, okay?
You better go find out what the facts are before you enter my world of pro wrestling. You don't turn away from me. You look at me man to man. Oh, you look at me.
I see him turning away there, Marcus. Well, I can understand the way he did that. I can't really condone battling out here, but Marcus, I understand this guy out here running his... You said it earlier about how this guy can get on all of our nerves, and I tell you what, maybe that'll teach him a little bit of a lesson, this Diamond Mike. Here comes Jack Hammer and Crusher Bones, a couple of guys from the Diamond Mike stable to help him out of here.
He asked for it. That's it.
He sure did. Boy, Marcus sure didn't turn away from him either. He didn't back up a step. He can talk about not having 10 men to back him up. I don't think Marcus maybe needs 10 men to back him up. He didn't seem to right there.
First and foremost, Marcus Dupree's an athlete, my friend, and that goes into all phases of it. He just happened to have been the greatest high school football runner, the greatest freshman runner Oklahoma has ever seen, and then on to pro football. We're ready for action in the ring.
Jack Hammer in the ring along with Scott Studd. And we're underway. Big Jack Hammer with a size advantage on Scott Studd. Scott Studd came into the area and rapidly became one of the favorites of the USWA fans. Jack Hammer, one of those rugged type individuals who uses telephone pole, broad arms, a fist, a choke, a chain, anything handy. And oh, by the way, did I mention he'll also use his manager, Diamond Mike, in the corner to gain advantage, too, if he has to.
Good point. Look at that Scott Studd move. He is quick. He goes right up. Boy, he bulldogged him standing still, and that's not easy with a guy as big as Jack Hammer. Hammer scissored right down on the mat. Lay the arm hook back into a hammer.
Scott Studd with great balance. Didn't let him set up on the hole, though, as Scott Studd takes the hammer up behind him, and Jack Hammer finds himself in a hammer lock. Not what he planned on being in, let me tell you. He thought he would have had this one going his way with one of those moves that he tried to put on Scott Studd a little earlier. Oh, my goodness. Diamond Mike's drink just spilled over in the corner out of that plastic pineapple he carries around.
Gracious goodness. Look at Hammer with that right. Referee Bill Rush starts to count on him. He goes to a whip. Scott Studd. He's caught with a much heavier Jack Hammer. And he was flinging one of his own at the time, but he just got ripped by that big arm. Count of one, count of two, and he got out of that one.
I thought he might have had him for the three count, but Scott Studd able to kick out at the count of two. Big Jack Hammer smashes him back into the turnbuckle, whips him across the way. Here comes Jack Hammer. There goes Scott Studd. He moved out of the way. He nails Jack Hammer. Doesn't get him off his feet yet, but he's got him hanging back on the ropes in the turnbuckle. Dangerously close to Diamond Mike. Oh, he just reached out, grabbed his foot, dropped it down to the mat.
And one, two, three, with Pete on the ropes. Scott Studd ends up getting hammered.
Here comes David Haskins out. He's telling Bill Rush exactly, and the crowd is terrified today.
Yeah, David Haskins explaining exactly what happened over here in the corner. Referee reverses the decision. Look out, Crusher Bones jumps in. Neil's David Haskins. Jack Hammer back in. And Diamond Mike climbing into the ring, too.
Thrown out of the ring was Scott Studd, and David Haskins, who came to scrape the referee out on the fact that not only did Mike pull the leg out, but there, oh, here comes Marcus Dupree. Marcus throws that right hand with authority, and out of the ring goes Hammer Crusher and Diamond Mike. And Haskins and his friend Marcus Dupree. He didn't do much wrestling, but he got the job done, Dave.
Boy, he certainly did. There's no doubt about it. Looking mighty good there, David Haskins and Marcus Dupree.
Hey, Dave, real quick, I just want to thank my main man, Marcus Dupree. Every match I've had in USWA, Diamond Mike sent his men out here. It's been 2-on-1. This week, 2-on-2. Marcus Dupree and David Haskins. Marcus doesn't claim to be a professional wrestler. He don't know anything about arm bars, and he don't know anything about wrist locks. But Marcus is from Philadelphia, Mississippi, and he does know about fighting. Marcus Dupree and David Haskins promise, Diamond Mike, this week, your boy's gonna get a good old Mississippi butt kicking.
What? Marcus Dupree took care of business right there. We're gonna take a break. We'll be back with more in a moment.
Shake it, no dandruff. You've got Selsun Power. Brush it, no flakes. You've got Selsun Power with Selsun Blue. Doctors recommend it number one over all leading brands. Dandruff problem? No way. You've got Selsun Power.
But Monica, I love you.
Romance on the rocks, Brad.
Chuck Woolery?
Why don't you tell us what happened?
Nothing. I dialed zero to call or collect.
And what should you have done?
Dialed 1-800-COLLECT and saved us some cash?
Would have been my move. Want to try again?
1-800-COLLECT. Yo, Chuck, do you mind?
And the pitch to Babe Ruth. How does he do it?
Maybe it was the caramel, the nougat, the peanut-packed power of a Baby Ruth.
The Babe's first cigarette of the day.
Baby Ruth from Nestle. This baby gets you going.
The temperature of your mouth, a steamy 98.6 degrees.
Ugh.
The temperature of a winter fresh mouth.
Taste my mouth.
Introducing new winter fresh gum from Wrigley's.
Yes. Icy cool flavor.
Oh, yeah.
Icy cool breath.
That lasts. Ooh. And lasts. Uh-huh. And lasts. We can't wait for your reaction. Try new winter fresh gum for icy cool breath that lasts.
I don't care what you have to do to catch the ball. Imagine it's the thing you want most in this world. Just catch it!
It all comes down to this play. What? He stopped at the 5-yard line?
A&W Root Beer. When you want one, you want one.
Main event time. Spellbinder climbs into the ring. Referee Bill Rush is there. And we are waiting for Spellbinder's opponent headed his way from the hood. It's Wolfie D headed this way for a single match here today. Wolfie's got the hubcap in one hand. The USWA tag title belt in the other. He, along with his partner J.C. Ice, hold the tag titles, PG-13.
Fantasy Island is where this big strapping Spellbinder is. Physically, this son of a gun is really a perfect specimen. Body's got a few things that he hadn't been able to put together to take him all the way to where he wants to go. On the other side, young man Wolfie D. Well, he doesn't have all of the beautiful physical things. He's not as big as Spellbinder, but brother, he is determined. He and that J.C. they want to do it more than just about anybody I've seen around for a while. Spellbinder, a cheap shot right at the eye as he was moving his arm across, shot to the midsection, and Wolfie not getting off to a good start.
Wolfie ducks under that one, comes with a kick, didn't get a good one, but it did knock Spellbinder off balance, and Wolfie, now he gets the drop kick and puts him down off his feet. Wolfie D off the middle rope. Spellbinder down on the floor, Wolfie D drops down on him.
He followed him right out. He knows about that fighting down on that hard pavement.
Yep. Back into the ring now. Spellbinder's head slammed into the top turnbuckle. A reversal on Spellbinder, but Wolfie D braced himself in the corner. Spellbinder's got him in the air. Oh, throws him down. I thought Wolfie was going to be able to press him down to the mat, but there's some of that strength of the Spellbinder. He couldn't do it.
He does have that. You saw him catch him right out of the midair and then take him right back over his head and down, and Spellbinder follows it up. The whip. Wolfie leapfrog and takes a spinning back kick from this big guy. Hard to believe a guy that runs around 275 can make that kind of a move, but we've seen him do it on several occasions. He does have that ability, and he also can do things like that, standing right on his neck while pulling on the rope.
After he hit him with a right fist, Spellbinder really became a much more successful wrestler after hanging around with Sid Vicious for a while. And he learned to do things like that, like stand on their head and hit him with a fist.
Picks up a few items from Sid that he put into practice, and now he's using them on Wolfie D. Puts the foot right on the throat and holding him back up against the turnbuckle before the referee got him off of there. The whip, Wolfie takes that big clothesline. And let me tell you, when this guy taps you with one, he has laid it on you. Count of one, two. Wolfie kicks his way out. That's that determination, Dave.
That's right. Wolfie's still on his feet and going after the Spellbinder. He was very close to a three count, but he's still going. Look at that. Grabs a Spellbinder. Oh, thinking about a pile driver. Uh-uh. Oh, look out. Look out. Doug Gilbert and Tommy Rich jump into the ring. That's going to be a disqualification on Spellbinder, but it's three against one against Wolfie D now.
Oh, you got the numbers just like you like them, don't you, Tommy and Doug? Sure. Get three on one. We're really tough. Nobody any tougher than we are in a three-on-one situation. As Wolfie D, last match of the show, but Dundee, good, he's still here. Here comes Bill, ripping away. Nails Spellbinder, Rich Gilbert, Wolfie back up, got his feet under him, swinging away on Spellbinder. Here comes Gorgeous George the third, as a pile driver pounded down on the Spellbinder. Gorgeous George the third goes to work on Wolfie. Tommy, Doug, they're concentrating on the superstar, Bill Dundee. And Dundee with a foot right on the jaw, and Wolfie takes an elbow from Gorgeous George the third.
Doug's got the hubcap there. Four against two, and now Doug with a hubcap choking Wolfie D. There's Bill Dundee being choked by Tommy Rich's foot. Brian Christopher to help out.
Christopher and J.C. Ice with a ball bat in hand. And they run them out of here. Thank goodness. Boy, I hate that three-on-one kind of thing that they go for. We're going to take time out, and we'll be back with a final word in just a moment.
Dog, Benji. Understand, choppers are in the air.
Confirm, border 40.
Mac, you tell me if you see any fire.
Okay, it's red sparks popping out right now. Okay, you're on fire. Okay, you're on fire.
There is a place pilots talk about, but few have ever been. It's a place where training, aircraft design, indeed a pilot's ability to stay cool, are put to the absolute test.
It's all coming out right where the hook meets the engine.
Copy. Presenting The Challenge of Flight, an exclusive new series that takes you where no aviation videos have ever gone before. Start with Final Approach. Be there when it all goes wrong. When raw power, fear, and the ejection seat is all the pilot has left. In incredible detail and first-hand accounts, you'll see what happens low and slow over a pitching carrier deck. Gear up with nowhere to go. And in the bunker when you test how bad it can be.
Okay, good. Keep that contact. You got choppers in the air. Confirm you're underway. Copy that.
Be an eyewitness to history as you watch exclusive footage declassified and released here for the very first time. Order your copy of Final Approach and go where few pilots have ever been before.
Send check or money order for $19.95 plus $3.75 shipping to Challenge of Flight, P.O. Box 2727, Department 27, Costa Mesa, California, 92628. Or for fastest service, use your credit card and call 1-800-457-1199. You'll begin with Final Approach. Other tapes will follow every 6 to 8 weeks. Cancel anytime. There's no obligation. Call 1-800-457-1199 now.
David, wish we had more time. We don't. Got to get out of here, buddy.
See you next week.
All right. Till then, for Dave Brown, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.